Welcome to the Farmhand Mike YouTube channel. I started this YouTube channel back in February of 2012, and thanks to all of you, my channel has now grown to over 175,000 subscribers, has over 100 million total views, and over 11.5 million hours of total watch time. Although most of my videos are farming videos, I do share my off-road adventures such as snowmobiling and ATV riding, and I'm uploading new content all the time. Hello and welcome back for another action-packed farming video. In this video, I am out visiting a farm near Baltimore, Ohio, as they are baling their wheat straw and planting double crop soybeans right into the wheat stubble. There are so many machines in this video that it's going to be a pretty long video as they are going through the whole process here. And we had some weather delays, so I was out here a couple different days getting this video shoot all done. In fact, the footage you're seeing right here, it started raining shortly after, so day one, I did not get a lot of footage. Also, as we go through this video, it was shot in a couple different fields, and you're going to see a bunch of different machines. They were running a total of 6 small square balers out here and a total of 5 bale barons. I missed out on this farm's wheat harvest. Now, the field you're seeing here was cut with a conventional head. The straw was winrowed and baled. And then coming up later, you're going to see a field where they actually use stripper heads. The stripper heads just take the head off the wheat and leaves the whole stalk standing in the field. They were coming through with the swathers and mowing that, winrowing it, and baling it because a lot of their customers like the longer straw. Which means in this video, you're going to see them swathing the straw, baling the straw, picking the straw up that the bale barons left behind in the bundles like you see here, loading it on the trucks, and then planting the double crop soybeans. The straw that you see them pushing in the trailer right here will be delivered to their customers, and they can just drop the trailer and the customer can unload the straw and sell the straw from these bundles. The bale baron puts 21 small square bales into one bundle like you see here. Up till this point, I have only seen bale barons at farm shows. This is my first video having them in the field in action. And like I said, they were running a total of 5 of them here. Thank you. we are about to get rained out. A pretty good storm had rolled through and shut everything down, so I'm back out here a couple nights later, and they're just getting back started. Now, I'm in a different field here than I was in the first part of the video, so they're out here swathing. Now, this wheat field here was harvested with a combine with a stripper head, so you can see that the wheat stubble is really tall. The stripper head just takes the head off the wheat, so this makes for some nice long straw. So they are out here swathing it. This farm runs two swathers to do this. First up, you see here is their New Holland H8040 with the New Holland Haybine head, and then you'll also see their Case International WD1203 Series 2 swather that also has a New Holland Haybine head on it. They're running the swathers about a day ahead of the baler. They don't want to go ahead and swath everything because if it does rain and they got these windrows of straw here, they're going to get wet. Then they're going to have to come in. They're going to have to ted them out and rake them. Sometimes they can't help that, but like I said, they're limiting how far ahead they get here. So this straw here will be baled probably the next day. They also have one of the balers running over here in another part of the field. Now the machines I was filming just a couple days ago that you've seen in the video already are still setting. It's a little bit wetter down there. And then later on in this video, they're gonna have all their machines up here running in the same field. And then in this very same field, they were just starting to get back to baling here. So up now is their Case International 380 Magnum tractor that is pulling a Marcrest 210 square baler. Now it's my understanding this is a pretty new baler for the market. Marcrest introduced these machines not too long ago. This is the first one I've actually seen out in the field running. And of course behind the baler, they are pulling a model 5250T bale baron. I posted a YouTube short and some Instagram pictures of this tractor baler and bale baron setup, and some people had asked what the tanks were for on the front of the tractor. This is their corn planting tractor, so the tanks are empty. They have nothing to do with what they're doing right here. I'm going to fly the drone back, land it, and I will be back in the morning, and they should have everything running. Here it is the very next morning. As you can see, the sun is shining. Weather looks to be good, so everything should be up and running here in a little bit. They're now raking up some straw with their Kubota L5460 tractor and Kuhn rotary rake. So this is straw that was rained on, and they tedded it out, and they're raking it up now for the balers. Unfortunately for the video, I was not here when they was tedding the hay, but that is a pretty nice International 5288 tractor. Thank you. Also out here in the mix, the farm has two Case International 75C tractors, both pulling Massey Ferguson 1840 small square balers. Now notice these balers are dropping the bales right on the ground. They are running one bale bearing behind a tractor that is just picking the bales up, and you're going to see that coming up here real soon. Thank you. Next up is their Case International 310 Magnum Tractor pulling a model 5250P bale baron. So this is keeping up with the two Massey balers that did not have the trailering bale baron behind them. So he's moving right along here, and he's able to keep up with these two balers. Again, this is bundling 21 small square bales into one big bundle. And I made it back for some evening shots. So the field that I was in at the beginning of the video that got rained out, they are just finishing up here. So there was two tractors still running here. They're Deutz Farr 6140 pulling the Massey Ferguson square baler and the bale baron. And they also had another Magnum over here with the same setup on the back. Now they did have to do some raking over here since this got rained on. Unfortunately, they were done with it and this tractor and rake did not make the video in action. But you get to see it anyhow. And once these tractors get done baling here, they will move over and join the other. And you also saw this tractor at the beginning of the video before they got rained out. This is their Case International 215 tractor pulling a Massey baler and the bale baron. So once this tractor and the Deutz finish up here, as I said, they will move over and join the others. Now their JCB and the Kinsey planter is over here running, so you're going to see that coming up in a little bit as well. Thank you. now moved back over to the other field here. The other two tractors and balers that I just filmed should be over here shortly. There's a lot going on to finish out this video. Just as soon as that straw is baled and those bales are hauled off, they are in here no-till planting soybeans with their Case International 340 Magnum tractor, pulling their Case International 500T no-till drill. And if you hear people talking about double crop beans or double crop soybeans, this is what they're talking about. I've even heard some farmers refer to them as wheat beans. And since these double crop soybeans are getting planted a little bit later into the season, a lot of times these will not be ready to harvest towards the end of October, first part of November. let's go in for a close-up of what the bale baron does. As I mentioned earlier, there is 21 small square bales in a bundle, and it looks like the bale baron wraps 4 total twine around the whole bundle to keep it together. That's going to wrap up this hour plus long video, but there was a lot of machines in this video and a lot of pretty interesting machines, especially those bale barons. Anyways, feel free to go down there and hit that like button, leave a comment if you're new to my channel. I would sure appreciate it if you go down there and hit that subscribe button and check back often. I'm always uploading new content to my YouTube channel. And if you want to see more of what I'm doing, you can follow me along on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok at Farmhand Mike. As always, thank you for watching and supporting my social media.